Very good evening, everyone. We are going to start the new chapter today, and which is the carbon and its compound. So first, we have to understand what is carbon. Okay. So carbon is the non-metal. Okay. Carbon is what? It is the non-metal having atomic number 6. So carbon is a non-metal okay, and it is represents by capital C. Okay, C is nothing but the symbol which is used to represent the carbon atom. Okay, so it's I'm writing here. Wait a second. I'm writing a carbon. Carbon. Okay, its symbol is C, capital C. Its atomic number. Atomic number of carbon is beta 6. Okay, its atomic number is 6. Atomic mass. Carbon have 3 allotropic form, isotopic form. One is called C12, second one is called C13, and third one is called C14. Okay, that means one of the isotope of carbon having atomic mass 12, other isotope have atomic mass 13, and the last isotope of carbon have atomic mass 14. Okay, everyone, you are getting the point, no? Everyone?
Yes, sir, we are.
Okay, so on carbon 12, number of proton we have 6. Neutron we have 6, but in carbon 13 we have proton 6 but neutron 7. In carbon 14 number of proton are 6 but number of neutron are 8. Okay, just to remember this important point. Okay, about the allotropes, isotopes of carbon. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these carbon 12, 13 and 14 are nothing but isotopes. Isotopes. So what are isotopes? Isotopes are the element having same atomic number but different atomic mass number. So I'm writing here isotopes are what? Element having same atomic number. Elements having same atomic number but different atomic mass number are called as beta isotopes. Okay, so we have 3 isotopes of carbon. See, atomic number is 6 but atomic mass is 12, so this is the first one. Atomic mass is 6 here, but atomic number is 6, but atomic mass is 13. So it is second isotope. Here atomic number is 6 and atomic mass is 14. So it is the third isotope of carbon. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now valency of carbon, electronic configuration. Of carbon. So carbon having 6 electron, therefore its electronic configuration will be beta 2 and 4. Somebody is in waiting room. Wait a second. Himanshu. Okay. So its atomic number is 6. That means carbon is having 6 electron. So its electronic configuration will be 2 and 4. Okay. It is very important. It is 2 and 4. Now, we'll discuss about the valency. What is valency? Anyone have any idea about valency?
Sir, it's the ability of a certain element to either gain or donate electrons.
Or in short, we can say valence is nothing but the combining capacity of an element. Combining capacity of an element. Sometimes what happens, most of the transition metal, they sometimes loses less electron, but they forms more bond. Okay, like coordination compound. Okay, so that's why we used to say combining capacity of an element means how many bonds with the elements going to bond with other elements or other atom is called as its valency. Okay, so combining capacity of an element is called as beta valency. And valency is determined by number of electron present in outermost shell of an atom. So we have already understood about octet rule. Is it everyone? Have you aware about octet rule?
Yes, sir.
Yes, what is octet rule is about? Octet rule says every element must have 8 electron in their outermost shell to acquire stability. Okay, it is given
in the inner, right?
No, in outermost shell, beta. Octet rule says every element must have 8 electron in their outermost shell in order to acquire stability. But in case of carbon, we have only 4 electron. Is it or not? So in order to make 8 electron, carbon will either lose or gain or share electron. Is it or not? Is it? So yes, carbon will share 4 electron with other element in order to form 4 bond. That means in order to have 8 electron here, so just subtract that 4 from the 8. Okay, so we will get 4. So 4 will be the valency of the carbon atom. So valency of carbon is 4. That's why carbon is called as tetravalent.
What, sir?
Tetravalent. Tetravalent means the element having 4 valency. Valency is 4, that means it is tetravalent. Tetra means 4 and valent means valency. Okay, carbon most of the time called as tetravalent element. Why? Because it has valency 4. It has valency 4. That's why it is called as tetravalent element. Okay? Understood?
Yes,
okay. Next point. Okay. Next point is allotropes. So, what are allotropes? Allotropes are elements having same chemical property but different physical forms are called as beta allotropes. Okay, substance which have same chemical properties. But different physical form, or we can define another way, like same substance appears in different physical form are called as allotropes. So carbon have main 3 allotropes. Number 1 we have diamond. Okay. Number two, we have graphite. And number three, we have Buckminster fluorine or buckball. Buckball, sometimes it is called as fluorine or fluorine, or it is also called as buckyball. Buckball, fluorine, or Buckminster. These are the name, different name for the same allotrope. Okay, so here we have discussed about the allotrope, the valency, okay, allotrope, then valency, then electronic configuration of carbon, then atomic mass and its isotope, isotopes, and atomic mass. Then we discuss about atomic number and the symbol of carbon atom. Okay, everyone, understood?
Yes, sir.
So, any doubt from here? So now we are going to discuss about the occurrence of carbon. Okay. So in our nature, okay, in our nature, carbon occurs in two state. Number one is called free state, or it is called as native state or native state. Okay, this is the first one. Second state is called combining state. Okay, combining state means in the form of compound, like we have carbon dioxide, we have carbon monoxide, okay, we have sodium carbonate Na2CO3, we have NaHCO3, it is sodium bicarbonate. We have calcium chloride, it is CaCO3. Okay, so all these are nothing but one of the kind of sources of the carbon atom, where carbon is present in combining state in the form of compound. Okay, it's called as beta. Here we have carbon monoxide. Okay, are called as the combining state of carbon. Okay, but in native state, okay, in native state, so carbon is present in the form of fossil fuel, in the form of diamond, in the form of graphite, in the form of fluorine, okay, then we have fluorine done. Okay, done. So, and all these are found in earth crust. All these are found in earth crust. Earth crust. Okay, and all these are present either in solid or in liquid dissolved form, which is the aqueous one. Okay, again we have in the form of carbohydrate like C6H12O6, we have in cellulose, okay, we have in wood, we have in cotton, we have wool. Okay, we are in the form of protein, we in the form of fat. Okay, so all these are the combining state of the carbon. These all are the examples. Okay, everyone. So in our nature, carbon occurs in two state. One is called native state, which is a free state, means in this form, carbon present in its pure form, beta, pure form. Okay, in pure form, it is present in the form of fossil fuel like coal, different forms of coal. Then we have diamond, graphite, fluorine. Okay, and all these are found in different layer of earth crust. Any doubt here, everyone? Everyone, do reply.
No doubts.
Okay, so take a screenshot for that. Okay, so now we are going to understand about the allotropes of carbon. So first we will discuss what is allotrope is about. Okay, so what is allotrope? So when a single substance appears in two or more different physical form are called as allotropes. Okay, are called as beta allotropes. Okay, understood? Compound or substance is the same, but they appear in different physical form are called as allotropes. Like carbon appears in three different physical forms. Number one, we have diamond. Number two, we have graphite. Number three, we have Buckminster.
Fluorine, right?
Yeah, Buckminster, fluorine, buckyball is the same.
Yes.
Or fluorine. It is also called as Buckminster. Okay. Or Buckminster. All these are the same. Okay. So why? We have one question. Why carbon is appearing in different physical form? It is due to the different in arrangement of particle. Okay, carbon shows difference in arrangement of particles in its crystalline form. Okay, they have all these allotropes are crystalline form of the carbon. Okay, they are crystalline. So let's discuss first, and which is nothing but the diamond. Okay, first allotrope of carbon is called diamond. Okay, so you know when fossilization process takes place, so the carbon which is present at the deepest layer of earth due to the high pressure and high temperature, okay, the particles get arranged themselves in the three-dimensional structure where one carbon atom is attached with four other carbon atoms like this. Okay, see here, if you can see here, this is the one carbon atom. Here we have second carbon atom. Okay, that carbon is first, this is the second, here we have the third, and here we have the fourth carbon atom. Okay, so in this way, a single carbon atom is bonded with four other carbon atom. That's why that structure is called as three-dimensional. It is a 3D structure. Okay, and in this arrangement of particles for the regular manner, for the long range, this property is called as catenation. This property to form the bond with other carbon atom, okay, in all possible direction is called as beta catenation, to form the large structure like diamond and graphite. Okay, this property is called as catenation. Okay, so let's discuss the point given over here. Okay, so diamond is one of the allotrope of carbon. Okay, diamond is one of the allotrope of carbon, where okay, one carbon atom is attached with attached with four other carbon atom. Okay, it's called as beta diamond. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is given here? The Lonslet hexagonal allotrope of the. Okay. So hexagonal is for the, not for the diamond, but it is for the graphite. Okay. It is for the graphite. But here it is again forming the hexagonal structure. But if we will see the geometry of each carbon atom when it form bonds with other carbon atom, okay, it forms the three-dimensional structure. It forms the three-dimensional structure. It is believed to form the graphite present in the meteoroids upon their impact on to the earth. Okay, so these are not the point in order to understand, but just whatever I'm writing, just to concentrate on that only. Okay, so first point we have discussed here, one of, what is diamond? It is one of the allotrope of carbon. Okay, wait a second. Let me. Okay. Okay, it is one of the allotrope of carbon where one particle is attached with, means one carbon particle is attached with four other carbon atoms. Okay, due to this arrangement, particles of carbon very compactly arrange with each other, and they have very high density as compared to other allotropic form. Okay, so when particles of carbon in diamond form, okay, when particles of carbon in diamond form arrange themselves very, very compactly. Okay, means particles of carbon in the structure or the crystalline structure of diamond, they arrange compactly, very strongly. That's why they have highest density among the other allotropic form of the carbon. Due to which carbon, like diamond form, having melting point about 3550 degrees Celsius or more than that. Okay. Melting point of diamond is more than 3550 degrees Celsius. Okay, everyone, are you getting the point? No?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the particles arranged in all the possible direction in 3D form, three-dimensional form. That's why, okay, it is a very strong and hardest substance found on earth. So I'm writing here, next point. Diamond is the hardest substance hardest substance found on earth? Okay, being non-metal. Being non-metal. Last but not the last, least point for the diamond. Diamond is the good conductor of heat, but bad conductor of electricity. Diamond is good conductor of heat, but bad conductor of electricity. Okay, everyone. So take a screenshot. Now we are going to discuss the second allotrope of carbon. Okay, and which is the graphite. Okay, so graphite is another allotrope of carbon. Another allotrope of carbon, where one carbon atom bonded with three other carbon atom in hexagonal geometry. Okay, in hexagonal geometry. Okay, see here, as you can see the arrangement of particle like this over here. Okay, see, one of the carbon, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Okay, and here every, like, these six particles form that hexagonal structure like benzene ring. Okay, and here one carbon atom. Okay, like here we have one carbon, second, and that third carbon. Okay, so in this structure one carbon atom is always bonded with three other carbon atom in two dimensional form. Okay, so geometry is two dimensional in 2D form. 2D form, it is two dimensional structure. Okay, so graphite is used in lead of the pencil, and sometime or most of the time it is used in for the making electrodes which are used in shell. Okay, because graphite is being good conductor of electricity. So I'm writing the here important point. Graphite is good conductor of electricity. Okay, why graphite is good conductor of electricity? Because they have delocalized electron in their crystalline structure. So I'm writing here reason also. Because in structure of graphite, in structure of graphite, delocalized electron are present, which helps in electrical conductivity. Okay, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that's why graphite is a good conductor of electricity. The most stable form of carbon. It is again one of the most stable form of the carbon. Graphite powder is used in dry lubricant. Why it is used in dry lubricant? Because graphite is found in different layer form. Like here we have one layer, second layer, third layer. See, when we are using the pencil, okay, so that pencil, that lead, when we are writing with the help of that lead, so here we have many layer, that graphite is formed by the many layer like this. So whenever you are writing, these layer are get stick with the page where you are writing or where you are going to write, that different layer of that graphite that stick on the paper and it appears in the black form. That's why pencil are being used for the writing purpose. Okay. So these different layer, they stick on the page and we are able to write on it. Okay. So due to this property, this layer slides over each other. That's why they are used for making the dry lubricant. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
A single layer of graphite is called as graphene. Very important. A single layer of graphite is called as graphene, and which is the transparent one. If single layer is present only, that graphene is the transparent in nature. Okay, so this is all about graphite beta. So take a screenshot for that also. Okay, in 1985, okay, in 1985, that Florin was the scientist who incident the high intensity of light on the graphite. Okay, suppose this is the rod of the graphite. Okay, here when high intensity of light is being incident on it, okay, that graphite splits down into the many like tiny particles like this. Okay, and when he observed them precisely, he found that there is the hollow structure like a football, okay, where one pentagon, see here we have one pentagon, this one is the pentagon, okay, is surrounded by five hexagon like this. Here we have the five hexagon. This is the first, this is the second, this is the third, this is the fourth, this is fifth, and this is the sixth one. Like this. Okay. So ultimately, this structure where one pentagon is surrounded by five hexagon, they forms the football-like structure. And one of the architecture who designed that structure, okay, of the fluorine, it was looks like the football ball only. Okay. That's why it is termed as the buckball. Okay, so the fluorine is nothing but the allotrope of carbon, which was discovered on 1985 when a high intensity of light incident on the graphite, it split down into the small particle. And when they observe that small particles, they appears like the football where one pentagon is surrounded by five hexagon and ultimately they form the ball-like structure. Okay, so Buckminster fluorine, or usually just fluorine, or the buckball for short, are the molecule of varying in size. Okay, so when they count the number of carbon atom in such a round like or ball like structure, sometimes they found 60 carbon atom, sometimes they found 80 carbon atom. Okay, like this. So number of carbon in the buckball is not constant. Okay. They compose of entirely of the carbon, which takes them to form the hollow. So whatever the carbon atom, they are combining with each other and they form the football-like structure. So inside them, the empty space is present. Okay, that empty space is called as the hollow structure. That's why the graphite has the hollow structure. Okay, and like a sphere. Okay, where under the study of the potential medicinal use, binding graphite antibodies to the structure to the target resistant bacteria and even the target certain cancer cells such as melanoma, they are treated by using the graphite only. Okay, most of the time graphite is fluorine is being very useful. Okay, it is used as active charcoal. It is used as an active charcoal, and you know that whenever you are burning something, so the soot particles are being released. Soot particles. These soot particles contain the structure of they contain like or they appears like the fluorine only. If you will observe them with the help of electron microscope, you will find they will appears like the football only. Okay. So these soot particles of carbon are nothing but the third allotrope of carbon called fluorine. Okay, everyone?
Yes, sir.